Okay, now the top edge is on there secure, see? So what I'll do is I'll spot weld that on there, then I'll work my way around the edges, and before I do that, I'll go ahead and suck this down. And that's gonna be quite a chore there, and I'm gonna have to show you how to do that. This is Pete. We're trying to show you how to do stuff. I'm, you know, doing the best possible way I can. You know, this doesn't apply to a Karmann Ghia. You can do this on any fucking car, okay? This applies to any car that you do, all right? This whole side has been replaced all the way down, okay? This is gonna be a really nice car. It's gonna be a show car. Now, if you notice right here, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but the door's touching the bottom quarter panel. Now what that's from, I still gotta stretch this, and I gotta stretch it a long way. Well, I don't even know, you know, I don't fucking, something ain't fitting right. But we'll get it fit on there and get taken care of. Okay, so what I've done, I went ahead and put a bunch of little spot welds. Now what I'm doing is I'm seam welding it up, see? And what I do to do that with is I take my air hose just like this, and I take my welder. And what I'm gonna do, this is called stitch welding. I went ahead and spot welded it on. Now I'm gonna stitch weld it in various places back and forth. So we'll start over here. I'm gonna get this little hole right here first. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull it down just like that. And what that's going to do, it's going to keep it from warping. It's going to keep the metal from warping when you're cooling it down with air. Now that it's giving it a little bit of a valley, but it's not warping up and down. It's going horizontal instead of up and down. So now I'll come over here and I'll get another little set. I'll finish this section off. These holes up yet. I still might need my slide hammer to pull that out. So we'll leave those holes there until we get done straightening it out. So I'm going to go back and forth until that whole section is welded. Then we'll come back and stretch our panel to fit. And I'll show you what I mean by that. Let me finish this out and I'll be back. So the next step on our obstacle course that we got going here is the bottom of our rocker panel, quarter panel, I'm sorry. The bottom section of our quarter panel. And what we gotta do, we gotta suck all that together, see? You see what I'm saying? I did that on purpose because these panels are not made to do what I'm doing. These are patch panels, okay? This is not a section made to design to do what I'm doing. This is a patch panel that's designed if you got rust in this area here to cut it out here. Or if this is all crushed in, you cut this little section out here and fit it in there. Okay? That's what you call a patch panel. And that's why they call it a patch panel, because you're patching. It's a job, you just gotta get in there and go for it and do it. Okay? So what I'm gonna attempt to do is I got me some long, they're actually 2-inch long, self-tapping number 12 screws, okay? And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna attempt to take these screws, I got four of them, so I got a good chance of doing it the right way. I'm gonna screw this in to my lower rocker, my lower quarter panel, and then screw it in to the bottom flange where it welds together. And hopefully that's gonna suck that all together and it's gonna make a real nice tight fit. Now, I'm going to attempt to suck this panel together. Now, what the problem is, why it's not fitting right, is two reasons, okay? First, it's an aftermarket, and second, actually three reasons. First, that it's an aftermarket from Zimbabwe or wherever the fuck it's from. And the second reason is that the fucking thing is shorter than it's supposed to be. It's not really contoured, okay? It's basically the same situation we had with our rocker panel here. It's just, you know, out of proportion, and it's not really fucking fitting right. And one more problem we have is that I really don't want to fucking do it. But I got to, and that's the way it goes. So here we go. See if we can get this screw right here. Let's try and get that started. See, I'm gonna go ahead and start that. Sucked it down. Now I gotta do the same thing over here, and I got three screws left. See, I got three screws, so it's a pain in the ass. It's a pain in the fucking ass, but it's gotta be done. Now, we do have a problem with our door jamb right here, but no need to fear, we will fix that. Okay, it will be fixed. We'll probably end up doing some body work to it. Probably end up doing body work. Let me get this right here. Long screws kind of suck. Okay. And now, as you can see, it's nice and solid, it's coming together, and I like it. I really, really like it. Whew. Big fucking job. Big freaking job. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna need one there. I can pound that. So there you go. Solid as a rock. Stretched in there, it stretched the metal. This is all solid now. And got a picture right here. That's it.
Hey,
yeah.
Somebody on the phone wants to know about that cabinet truck.
Yeah, we still got it. Hang on, I'll come up there and talk to him.